Ripped from the tapestry of history, this is Threads of the War, personal, truth-inspired flash fiction of the 20th century's war. I'm Jeremy Strozer.
Hi, folks. Jeremy Strozer, and I'm going to be recording for you today a Threads of the War called Child of Ice. Hopefully, you enjoy it. Child of Ice.
Quiet! He'll hear us!
My brother whispers with his authoritative tone.
I am being quiet. You be quiet!
I snark back as I duck under the window to be on the same side as Halidor. Peering through the bottom corner of the window, I can make out one of the green men standing before the counter.
What do you see? Holly asks.
Always relying on me to be his eyes and ears, he probably doesn't even want to put his big head in the window, giving us away to the invaders.
He's cutting potatoes,
I whisper to Holly's red ear.
Andre, get a better look. He's up to something,
Holly sternly whispers back.
Why are you always ordering me to do what you are too afraid to do yourself, big oaf?
I look up through the window again, this time catching the green man with short-cropped hair and a look of efficiency mixed with longing as he drops sliced potatoes into a frying pan.
What? Frying? Potatoes? He's frying potatoes!
I laugh a little too loud. Grabbing my arm, Holly yanks me as he orders,
"Let's go! Let's go! That hurts! Holly, that hurts! Let go!"
I scream out. Holly doesn't let go, but drags me back toward our house.
Let go, Holly. Let go of me,
I scream.
Holly, take your hands off your brother,
Mama calls out from our front door.
Oh, Mama, thank you. Mama, Mama,
Holly screams as he runs up to our door.
Mama, the green man was frying potatoes.
Mama runs her right hand through Holly's blonde hair as I catch up to clutch Mama's left hand.
Now, boys, don't be spying on our guests.
You know better than that, she says in a stern voice, only used when talking to both of us at once. I hug Mama's hand, comfort at the familiar. Holly looks up at her face as she lowers her eyes at him.
What nonsense, she says. Nobody would fry potatoes. You must not have seen right. We fry clenure and parta, but not potatoes.
I knew it. Those green guests are strange. Holly glares at me, a look of pending retribution in his eyes.
Ha!
I told the truth and it still made you say something almost as stupid as you look, Holly. On May 10, 1940, the British invaded Iceland to ensure it would not fall under German control. Prime Minister of Iceland, knowing he could not stop the invasion, broadcast to his people to invite the British in, treating them as guests in their homes. The British soldiers then took up residence in homes throughout the country. In one occurrence, two boys were spying on a British soldier making his meal when they spotted him frying potatoes. They could not believe it. No one in Iceland had ever heard of frying potatoes. When they returned home, they told their mother, who did not believe anyone would fry a potato. Only years later did one of the little boys come to the United States and order a burger and fries without knowing what it was. He found out fried potatoes are very good indeed. You think he called his mother?
If you enjoy these threads of personal experience and war, please consider becoming a patron of this work at patreon.com/threads of the war. You may find my books and other work at jeremystrozer.com or wherever books are sold. If you are interested in turning notes, memories, or memoirs of a relative into a living history through such work, please reach out to me at jeremy@jeremystrozer.com. May the lessons of history compel the world toward peace. Thank you.